it's hard watching this, not to continue to go off on Russo, but I think this show has been a great representation of why for so many years I've had a problem with Vince Russo. This show should tell everybody everything, at least how I feel. And I think based on your reaction today, how you feel. It'll be interesting to see how Vince Russo reacts to the show. He'll probably never want to, you know, be a part of any of your events again. He's a sensitive soul, you know.
No, listen, I like Vince Russo and I appreciate his work, but I can also say, I mean, cause he had a lot of great shit. This is a miss because I feel like he's trying to just say, hey, here's the Attitude Playbook and I'm just going to drop it in WCW. That wouldn't work. Like, and we're seeing like that happened in Alabama college football. We're seeing a new head coach come in and try to implement a new system with somebody else's players. It doesn't work. Like, you got to have the audience is not conditioned for this. Like if I took my kid, I didn't have a kid in 99, of course, but if I took my kid to go see their favorite wrestlers in WCW and they're doing all this, it would be like, boy, this is a little far removed from Sting in the Rafters and all the shit that made us a fan of this originally. And I understand that's got to evolve, but to the point where we're mocking wrestling and having girls that we don't know. I don't know any of those girls. They're not professional wrestlers. They're adult entertainers. And it's not like this is a crossover segment or in the first hour. This is right before the main event where it's Goldberg and Bret Hart. So here it is, man. Goldberg and Bret Hart in the main event and fans are standing. This is how you position stars. You know, I don't know that I necessarily love the idea of the last segment. I just want to recap what happened. We saw Kevin Nash and Scott Hall in a tag team affair. It was a handicap tag team match against three female strippers. And Goldberg came out and speared everybody in sight. And then he went back to his locker room and we shot the whole entrance from him walking out of the locker room surrounded by security who weren't just fucking there in the very last segment. Like the idea that those two segments touch to me, Eric, makes literally no sense. How do we have a special entrance after he just ran out by himself? What are we doing? Why wouldn't he have just stayed down there, picked up the mic and called out Bret Hart? Why don't we go all the way to the back, spray ourselves down, headbutt ourselves on the fucking deal, strap on our belt, find JJ Dillon's ass, get a couple state troopers, get our pyro going. What are we doing?
We're having fun. We're out there pretending that we know how to write a wrestling show. And I think Russo may have, I wasn't there, but I've heard others who were there when Russo was there in WWE. And I think you've heard the term filter. You know, I think Russo as a part of a much more experienced creative team could be an asset.
Yes.
Russo in charge of a creative team is a fucking disaster, which is what we're watching. Therein lies the difference. Russo could be a part of a team, a good part of a team, because he does think in terms of big moments. He's got some good instincts. He just doesn't have enough experience producing television and understanding how to tell stories to be much more than a segment producer. That's the difference. He was surrounded by people that knew more than him. In WCW, he was surrounded by people who knew less than him. There, that's it.
Man, I do like a lot of Vince Russo's work, and I appreciate some of his genius ideas, and I just like him as a human being. I mean, I've had a lot of really good conversations with him, and I think if he lived close, like we'd probably hang out and watch sports together. Like I like him. And I know that upsets a lot of people and you want to cancel me and that's fine. I just treat people how they treat me and whatever. But I will say, dude, and again, I said at the top of the show, don't know shit about wrestling, don't know shit about TV, but the format or lack thereof of this, where, I mean, we set ourselves up for failure here just on the format alone. The talent that's on the show is incredible. The presentation of the lighting and the pyro and the ring and the set and the entranceway. And I really like a lot of the little things like the threads throughout the show for these individual angles and stories. I like that. I like that we're getting some backstage use. I do like the job they're doing with Mike Tenay, positioning him as the straight man interviewer. I like the little preview of seeing guys get ready for their matches. There's a lot of good stuff on this show, but there's certain things like Goldberg just doing a run in and then going back to his locker room for the elaborate entrance. Man, you can't put the toothpaste back in the tube. We've already seen him now. Like, formatting would have made such a big improvement on this show. And it's just those little things, I think, that took this show from where it could have been a great show, or at least a very good show, to where it's more of a head scratcher when it's done.
And that's one of the things I harp about, you know, when people wonder, why are you so negative? Why are you always, you know, cutting down this AEW for this or for that? And it's because this is a simple fix, or it would have been a simple fix a year or two ago. It's going to get much harder as they continue to lose audience. Gary Considine told me once your audience decides to vote with their remote, it's really tough to get them back. And AEW is getting to that point if they're not already past it. But the solution is a lot of what we're talking about here. A lot of the flaws in this show that we're talking about and reacting to are the same flaws that exist in AEW right now. How many times have people heard me talk about formats? And I understand that a lot of times people that are hearing me don't necessarily understand what I'm talking about when I say format. It's more of a, it's not an insider term, but to someone who's actually producing television, they understand the absolute necessity of a great format if you want to grow and build your audience, or build and grow your audience. And I don't see it in AEW, just like we're not seeing it here. And it's one of the things that frustrates me the most. And it probably comes off as anger or whatever. It's not. It's just not that hard. Just do it. Just acknowledge that you have a problem. So keep an open mind to the fact that maybe there's a way to format your show so that you don't have to, you got great talent, you've got all the assets, you've got everything you need. You just need to figure out a way to present it in a way that holds people's imagination, because what you're doing is compelling, as opposed to throwing matches up. Or in Vince Russo's case, he's not necessarily throwing matches up, because he didn't give a shit about great matches, but he loved great segments. He loved great backstage stuff. He loved those scenes where people are chasing each other with cars and shit. That's how he got his jollies. That's what he wrote for. That's what he had a sense of. Anything else to do with the television show, he was fucking clueless and still is. Tony, go back and look at this show. Ask yourself honestly, if you can, am I making some of these same mistakes? And if I am, let's go fix them.